consolidated into the learning campus, which is in Dixon City. And that was an overall savings, and that is allowing us to have a building open. We were running a deficit of almost $200,000 in an early intervention program, and that was on chopping block this year. And for next year as well, and of course you run EI up here, so you know that that's a vital service. We service right now 1,052 kids, and if we walked away from that MAWA, that's 1,000 kids not serviced. Now, the state's required to do that, but I think we do it well. So, bottom line is we're working through a project with CM3. Bill gave us high regards, to renovate and repair the Jefferson Center and consolidate all of our Lackawanna County EI operations into one building, which will reduce our travel. You know the drill. Economies of scale should be great. So back to Jennifer, she's doing a great job. We're thrilled to have her. We did create the next page in your handout is what I titled the variance report. And there's a little bit of, there's a little history in this. You may remember over the past 5 years when you got this book, it said change of your contribution. It said zero for 5 years. That hasn't been true. It's not possible. And I'm going to walk you through the calculations shortly. And what was true was the 963 hasn't changed for 5 years. But how the 963 is broken out by district has to change every single year because it's based on your WADA, your weighted average daily membership. That changes every year. So for my predecessors to tell you your change was zero, it wasn't accurate. So this variance sheet had everybody, when they saw the real numbers, and Jennifer's trying to be very transparent to show you real numbers because you need real numbers to plan a budget. So they had everybody in a complete uproar because it didn't say zero, and everybody's expecting a zero. But again, it hasn't been true, and I'll show you why. Here's the best analogy I can give you to this IU funding stream. It's just like transportation. We won't know your 16-17 WADM until June of this year, because it's not over yet. And you report your WADM in June. So the best the IU could do is give you an estimate from our latest data. So every December, we get a letter from PDE giving us what your actuals were. So Jennifer took your most recent actual and plugged that in rather than just saying it's 963, y'all have a zero. It's not true. So now we're going to say, so that you can plan for your budget, the last data we have for Western Wayne was a contribution of 83,662. Not the 85 that we've been telling you for years was zero, and that's been holding true for 4 or 5 years. We've used the same number. We're not doing that anymore because I don't think it helps you and it's not transparent. So, how does that formula work? And I think that's kind of where everybody has the upset factor of why. First of all, we don't control it. The only thing the intermediate unit controls is the $963,000 number. Every other factor in this formula that you see in front of you, this colored page, that's all created by the state or through your data. Now, to make this really simple for you, go right to the top of the page. I think you're on this page, sorry. I'm sorry, I didn't walk you to the next page. If you go right to the top of the page, that's the math problem. So, the constant of 1, column 1, every district has a constant of 1, your 1 district. Column number 2 is your district aid ratio. That comes from the state. If we take the 1 minus your district aid ratio, that gives you column 3, a net aid ratio. And I'm going across the top. We take your net aid ratio, which in Western Wayne's, if you go near the bottom, it's 0.8946. That gets multiplied by your WADM. So think about this. I created a budget for you folks 2 months ago. I don't have your WADM yet, so I have to guesstimate. So I took... Bottom is your weighted average daily membership. It's your attendance. It's the number of students
like
that come.
Military, are we that?
I'm sorry. Yeah, please.
It would be easier to say attendance.
Yeah, that's your attendance.
Sure.
Yeah,
sure.
Please stop me if I'm giving.
I think you just like sure. to say water.
So we don't know that. So I think you could see the place where it would be impossible for me to tell you your change in contribution is zero in December of 16 when I don't have your factors until June of 17. And it's just like your transportation budget. You get reimbursed on the previous year's expenses. So your next year's budget for transportation is a guesstimate. So that's probably the best analogy I could give you with this. So we take your net ratio times your average daily membership, the kids who come here, and that gives us a district weight factor. And you see Western Wayne is 2,139. Column 6 is the value per weight factor. So if you flip your page, this is how we get the weighted value. And we're going to come back. So we take the $960,000, that's the only number we give the state, and we multiply that by the previous page's total. So we take column 5, add it all up, and that gives you a total of 24,638, and we divide that into 963,000. So that tells us that each factor costs you $39,000. So now we go back to the previous page. So we take the $39.11. My apologies, $39.11 per volume, per weight factor, and that equals your withholding. So that's where we generate the number from. So I think you can see the discussion here outside of the $963,000. We have nothing to do with this. So you just have to stop having really good property values,
right,
and you'll be less. That's right.
The gain ratio, because we're doing well.
That's correct.
That's long compact.
That's correct.
We end up paying lion's share compared to private loan.
Sure. That's exactly right. So a school district that may have more students than you have, but have less property values, has a higher market value aid ratio, so you pay more than them because they have less money, quote unquote, to pay.
I think what we do say is where we run our own classes.
Sure.
What, we did that in 97 with a
sure.
guy you walked
sure,
before
yes.
you
that is not. That is strictly, that aid ratio is strictly property value. It has nothing to do with the
market value.
Market value. It has nothing to do with the way we're handling our books or any of that. So you're
absolutely
accurate.
You're
that's
right.
Pretty much what we pay, except for some additional things that they do for us at the IU, the money amount. The 83,000.
Right, and because our special ed is not included, we do have some specialized students that go.
Right, yeah, that's what I'm saying. We only have a minimal, whatever
the operating budget.
Because we have everything else.
And that's the one you sent somebody that we're using, we pay per student?
That's correct.
All paid?
That's correct. So, let me take a breath and see if any of you have any questions on any of those sheets I went over, whether they're the budget sheets or whether it's the formula. I'll give you a second to chew on it, or as much time as you like.
I just have one question.
Sure.
On the first page that you went over in the middle section,
mm-hmm.
the three-year budget comparison, the expenses, even the revenue, 15, 16, and 16, 7,
yep.
there's like a
$3 million
difference.
Yep.
Like what was that a grant? Or?
No, that's a great question, and it really is a matter of being transparent. If I don't have the previous years, but it's very simple to look at. If we go to, I'm going to give you one specific section of it. If you go to page, the curriculum page, and you go on the expense side all the way at the bottom, medical access pass-through, you don't see it because we don't have the 15-16 year. We never put in the budget the pass-through. So if you go through this budget, every place there's pass-through, it adds up to almost $3 million. And we put that in an effort to be transparent because we're handling $3 million of your money. But it was never reflected in the budgets back how you asked, you know, it was so tangled up.
Yeah.
So there was $3 million moving through the IU that
was unaccountable for.
The auditors knew it was there, and the auditors came in and knew it was there, but
okay.
you didn't know it. So, and if you look at that same number, now this is a really good point you look at. Same page. You see in 16-17 it was $320,000,
okay.
and now you see it's 20. That's pass-through money, and here's what ended up happening. In 15, 16, 17, we used the previous year's number because Jennifer was brand new and I was brand new, so we have nothing to work off of. The auditor said, we can't audit your books, so the best we could do was pull the year before his budget. In 16-17, the year we're sitting in, you folks have only requested $20,000 worth of drawdown of medical access pass-through. So that's the number we put in there. This is strictly a sum zero game. So right now, we're using a budget holder of 20 grand. If you request more, we get more. The offsetting revenue side of that column is over on the right-hand side, and you'll look at GR060, five up from the bottom, and you'll see that matches, 20,000 and 20,000. So if we have a larger drawdown of medical access numbers, that's going to go up. I expect it will. I know right now one of our larger districts is sitting on hundreds of thousands of unbilled medical access. So again, Jennifer is strictly working off the concrete numbers that we have in hand. So I know that that 20,000 is going to go up by at least 100, but it's going to go up on both sides. And it doesn't mean a darn thing to Western Wayne because it's just their pass-through money. All we do is handle it.
You're saying there's people that are indebted, other school districts not paying their bills?
No. When you have students that qualify for medical access billing, that money comes through us.
Okay.
So for allowable expenses for medical access, you have to bill, and then that money is funneled through us. They haven't billed for it yet, so obviously there's some folks that don't need the money.
Yeah, I see what you said.
That's all. It has nothing to do with us.
We do the majority of our medical access ourselves because we run the special ed programs here.
Right.
We do have a small fund over there for a couple of students that would be eligible in their programs, but probably $2,000 is all we have in the fund, and I kind of keep track of that. When we need something, we spend it.
So that's a great question, and the short answer is, it just was never reflected in the budget, and I didn't think that was right. You know, and I knew I was going to, when I went out to the districts last year, and they were going to hit me over the head saying, you went from $3 million to six, but it's transparent. There's no new money, no new expenditures. They just weren't giving you all the money moving through the IU. And again, no malfeasance, just sloppy.
Very sloppy.
So now it's not anymore, and we're proud of that.
Yeah.
So people are working
hard. That's a hard turnaround down there. Because people were talking and they were tired of what went down before.
Sure.
And to see it coming back and balancing it off.
I think so, and I think to not only hold the line, and in this climate we have of rising expenses, health care, ESRs, salaries, every contract we write have raises built in, I'm committed to reducing that and having less of a contribution next year.
Can I ask a question?
Sure.
You might not like it, but I always like asking it. I did it in the 90s, I did it here. Bottom line is, it is out of the children with disabilities, physical or mental, what's the percentage of parentally disabled parents and those children suffer by it? Because you know what, it really bothers me that a lot of these children are coming in and they're lost for help at home, whether we're servicing them in special ed, and then they go home and there's nobody there and they lose ground, or they don't care. I mean, those children are not taken care of from day one.
I don't know the percentage, but
isn't it high though?
Anecdotally, we can tell you that sometimes some of the disabilities are generational. There's no question.
But I mean, they're parental, a lot of it.
Yeah, low incidence disabilities,
autism,
and all those, they're not.
For the child. Yeah, it's pretty sad.
But when you talk about learning disabilities, they tend to. We have seen a correlation where that is generational. But the low incidence disabilities, autism, genetic disabilders.
What do you do about something like that when parents just don't care about the children that they bore, and then the responsibility is all of ours, and the cost of special ed is tremendous? Something needs to be done. It's sad.
It is sad because there's a lot of good work done in schools, and these are our most needy kids. It's not unlike even our non-disabled students. We get 6-7 hours with them, and that's all we get. So, sometimes even our non-disabled students that are quite capable don't have the help they need.
You give them everything you got, and then when they go home, it's like the bottom falls back out again.
Yeah, there's a lot of retooling we have to do when they come back to us.
Yeah.
I wish I had an answer.
Yeah, I wish I knew how many we saved through all that thick and thin. Maybe Matt, you could look into that. You know what I mean? Just for a
What's that?
Hey, that's his job.
So, any other questions on the packet?
Yeah,
we
do a good job.
Well, that's right.
I mean, be a great deal, great resource.
Yeah, you're right.
But you're right, there are some that.
But it's a shame that we sell these because you just get nowhere because of their whole life.
Yeah.
And then there's, the next page is a single photocopy page that talks about boats. And that's just another illustration that this isn't one for one. It's not one district, one vote, or one person, one vote. It's all based on the same factors that we had earlier. So this was last year's vote total. And Mr. Gershey just thought it would be a good thing to see that everybody doesn't get a single vote. Yeah, when you look at Scranton last year had 99 votes. Is what they came out with when you do the math. So
I didn't realize that.
It's just what the math is.
Kind of comes out of it. That's what part of the solar taxation without representation in essence. Layman's paying $29,000, right? We're paying $83,000. We both get two votes.
Right.
So why? How does that? I get the balance comes off these other sheets.
Two different formulas.
But this formula. Should be proportional. I think the amount we're actually.
Yeah, it's not. This is two separate formulas.
Is this a state formula or is this a.
Yep.
This is,
are you sure that's Lackawanna County formula?
Absolutely not.
This is IU's
formula. No, this is a state formula as well. We get both of these formulas. The formula for both of these usually don't come until late February, early March. So we will be getting new formulas for the vote very shortly, and we won't get, of course, the numbers for your. Subsidy calculations until after June. We don't get notified until December of the following year. And that was kind of what tripped us up when we were building the budget. We were looking at old documents and we're looking at that. You know, if you think about the odds of having a zero contribution, every single person on that colorful sheet that we looked at earlier, that would mean all of column two across 20 districts would have to have no change. All of column four would have to have no change. So your district market aid ratio couldn't change for 20 different districts, and you don't have to set up the same membership for 20 different districts. So if you happen to get a zero contribution from one year to the next, play the lottery. Because it just almost mathematically can't happen. So what I'm trying to impress upon you there is we're working really hard to be transparent so that when we tell you something, we want you to trust that it's going to be true and accurate, and you can feel good about that.
I got another one that we can. When you have your superintendent meetings sit down at the TIO, mm-hmm. Do you discuss this budget a lot with what the state's not doing mm-hmm. in regards to their fair share?
We do, as a matter of fact.
The Constitution states that the government will pay 50%, state government, and local districts will pay 50% of the revenue. We're at 65%, and the state government is paying us 35%. They're breaking the law.
The unfunded mandates are.
But they're breaking the law anyway, by their funding.
Sure.
Can't we do nothing about that with our superintendents, with your meeting, and set up a delegation with some local board directors?
You know, we tried. We
did
had,
you try that?
We
when
did.
Did you try that, though? I don't recall.
Last year?
Last year. Okay.
What was it? It was right before the budget impasse. We invited all of the member senators and representatives to the IU,
right.
And the supers were there.
Mm-hmm.
And call it what it is, but only the Democrats show up.
They don't want to do that. The Republicans are fighting the Democrats, are fighting the Republicans.
It was just that. When
Eddie Rendell was in, he asked all the boards and all the districts, give us an idea what you think would be good. We came up with a proposal and sent it to all of our constituents in Harrisburg. And the State of Board of Education. And the bottom line, we went with a 1% increase in sales tax.
Mm-hmm.
And 1% was to be locked in by law for education.
Yeah.
And they never did nothing. They just played a game, asked us for our advice. We gave it to them, and they didn't do nothing about it.
It's complex, and you know, I'm sure you folks, your administration can tell you, even the current budget is has people concerned because those districts who were financially responsible like you will get penalized because of the hold harmless. So you know, the districts who were running roughshod through spending will probably get a better shake. Because they're going to try to keep the numbers flat and move forward from the fair funding formula. So the other, just to give you an insight of what's happening,
yes.
I was formerly in Susquehanna County as a super,
right.
And we had a forum with our legislators, and of course, we were in the gas area, so there's an awful lot of money coming in, and just a very good insight that we got of the dealings of state government. We, our board members were saying, we want the gas dollars to stay here. It's our money, we're generating it. And without blinking an eye, the representative was there and said, we've had this conversation in Harrisburg, and Pittsburgh and Philadelphia said, great, we want our tax revenue then, because we generate all the sales tax.
Okay.
So they said, you can keep your gas money, we want the sales tax. And of course, once you do that, now everybody's got some skin in the game, and it's not as simple as it looks, so it's tough. Fortunately, we're all into the...
I'm for an extraction tax, and I don't know that much about it, but it take care of the regions, give them what they need to upgrade their roads and stuff, and a little bit extra for being the host, and then put the rest into public education, or to Harrisburg, but then we can't trust, like you said, where it goes. So I don't know,
it's like a black hole.
You tell them when it gets down there, then all of a sudden it evaporates real quick. It's like Act 1. Act 1 is the new walk-around money, because it was the reduced school property taxes. And what they did was they gave us a stipend. It's been the same for the last 7-8 years, whenever it started. And they take the other money, because there's a lot of money coming in gambling, we all know that. It never increased, so they just take care of their pet projects so they get reelected. It's new walk-around money. I mean, it's obvious what they're doing, and we need to change in Harrisburg more than we need to change anywhere else. So I need your help.
Where are you in here? Huh? Well, we have someone coming at our next superintendent's meeting from the state for the fair funding formula, which fortunately the legislature passed. There were some folks that did well. You know, if you talk about the fair funding, the new formula with Abington, they were mad as hatters because they didn't do as well as some of the other districts. So, you know, it's such an uneven situation. There's always winners and losers, and I guess whoever's loudest at the table or who has the right connection.
When Senator Mello was there, he's a friend of mine, but he did more for Valley View, the same size school. We had a big tax. We always had it come up a lot shorter in revenue than they did. Sure. So he took care of his home base.
Sure.
And probably a lot of them knew that, obviously, as we said.
The last sheet is a summary, and I'm not going to read it to you. And it's not comprehensive. It's an amalgam of the best I could put together that I've been working on for the past year and a half. And these are some of the things that we do. Some of them are fee-for-service. Some of them are part of the budget. Some of them are part of special education funding. This is a soup to nuts. So this isn't meant to say, hey, we do this for $900,000. This is what we do. And some of you who are new to the board or new to the details we do, these are some of the things we do. So I guess what I would say in very short summary, if there's something on here that you think we need to do, call the super, and we'll work on getting it delivered.
Just getting through it, there are many things in Western Wayne participates.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And I'm sure you forgot it. Yes, sir.
As that scales back, and you said we're going to be, our responsibility is going to decrease in our contribution. So would that cover all of this still? Okay, so is there going to be, are you going to formulate like an a la carte where
pricing? Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
So this will cost this will cost that.
Yeah, what we've done, our curriculum director has put out to the supers, and this has got, it's got to be 18 months now, a rough framework for fee-for-service models, and they'll be kind of free, and then there's full pay. So we will have an a la carte menu out there. One of the things that I'm hoping to do, and I'll stop talking, because I know you have a board meeting. But one of the things we're trying to do, and I've charged all our department heads with, is generate new revenue streams. And one of the places where we're working the hardest on that is in that MIS department, because that's the place where we can generate enough revenue. And I'll ask for your forgiveness. Don't be upset if you ever see the ad getting into something that doesn't seem educational. If we're making money, then I apply it